Tu gardes tes pieds là.
Bon, ouais. New pistons, rebuild kits for the engine. Whole lot of work to do.
What else is in there? Head gasket.
New valves. Valve guards. Gasket set. And rings for the pistons.
Keep you busy for about a week or two, eh?
As you can imagine, rebuilding the engine involves quite a few different steps. In the first one was to drain all the coolant and oil. Once that was done, it was time to start disassembling all the different bits and pieces, like the fuel and oil filters, the cooling system, and so on. The engine started to look more naked, and the pile of parts was growing.
Doing there?
Oh, taking all the head bolts off so we can remove the head and send it in for new valves and new valve seats.
We are lucky to have great access to our engine. But taking the head off is still quite a mission. Moving a heavy part like this required all hands on deck to get the job done. With the head off, it was the perfect time for Pete to double check the size of the piston and the clearance inside the cylinders. Next step was to label and remove any wiring before it was time to get knee deep into the oil.
And we have the mechanics at work on the rebuild of the engine here. This side is Cameron. What are you up to, Cameron? Talk to the Cameron.
I'm undoing the bolts for the sump bolts.
And on the other side of the engine there is Christina.
I'm doing the same as Cameron.
The other side of the oil sump.
Yeah.
I'm going to remove the oil sump to get to the camshaft, so we can take the pistons out.
We've got the sump all tied up so we can take the last bolts out. I ain't gonna just drop into the bilge.
With the oil sump off, we got access to start taking the pistons out, and we also cleaned off any old bits of gasket off the head, prepping it ready to be sent to the workshop. And then it was time to remove the pistons. As we removed them, Pete was able to have a good look at them, finding evidence of blow bar on the pistons, which had been back pressuring our engine. We could see it's been getting past all of the rings by the carbon buildup. We also found wear on the big end bearings, so we needed to replace those as well. Each piston that we removed, we had to disassemble, get the conrod out, and cleaned up, ready to put together in the new piston set.
What you doing there?
Just making sure the oil ports or lubricating the bearings are cleared. And something important is to, before you put the shaft in, is to oil up all the surfaces that the shaft's going to go through and run on. Because well as oiling the shaft itself. There's the number, is it there?
Okay, so there's a number there.
And the valve clearance is on the same side of the number. So what we'll do is just push the shaft in first. With a bit of luck. Before you put the circlip in, check it, number's there, recesses for the valves there, it's the right side, and the circlip can go in. There we go, other circlip in, piston secured, and we'll put the rings on just before we install the pistons into the cylinders. There we go, we can pack this away, ready for the next rainy day.
With that job done, it was time to get back to the cylinders and work on those honing the inside. We bought this neat tool that attaches to the drill. It has grinding stones on a little spring system, and we will show you now how to use it. The very first step is to put a cloth at the bottom of the cylinder to cover the crankshaft so no filings drop down. Then you oil the inside of the cylinder, and then you carefully insert the honing tool and start the process. Even after the first short go with it, you can see a massive difference to the others. One by one, we did each piston. Until we were happy with them, and they looked so much better. We also got cracking on a few other jobs, replacing seals and gaskets that all came with our rebuild kit. And we also cleaned up other parts like the oil sump, and other systems and parts like the cooling system. Some just needed some wire brushing. Others required a bit more creative thinking to get cleaned. The last thing to do before the pistons could go back in was to put the new rings in. And then it was time to fit them back.
What's happening, Peter? What's the problem here?
Getting those rings into the cylinders.
Seeing it was nearly impossible to fit the piston and keeping the rings in place, we got ourselves one of those nifty little tools. The way it works is you ensure the rings are all staggered at 90 degrees, and then you slide this little sleeve on and tighten it up so it keeps the rings in place and makes fitting the piston back so much easier. Check off the workshop manual gave us the correct torque for the connecting rod bolts.
That's the sound, eh?
That's the one.
And just like that, one was done, and five to go. Meanwhile, the head had come back from the workshop. And it was time to fit the heavy thing back on. And once back on, put it all back together, starting with all new head bolts. Once again, the workshop manual had all the information on correct torque and tightening sequence that needed to be followed. With the head back on, it was time to put the rest back together.
Just installing the diesel return, but you've got to watch out, all the little washers and things don't fall down into the engine or you've got a serious problem. So best to block up the holes. So we're just checking the tappet clearance and we've got a little guide here that will tell us when 1 and 4 is totally open, you adjust, it's at 6 and 12, 8 and 9 and 12, sorry. So at the moment we've got 7 and 11 which are open, it's compressed down and it's opened the valves. 9 and 11, so we're going to check 2 and 6, we know the gap is 0.46 millimeters. So you go to 2, Should be a nice fit into there, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and a nice fit into there. So that's what we're doing now, is just checking the clearance of the tappets.
Once Pete had checked the tappet clearance, the cover went back on, and it was time to fit all the rest back onto the engine. And then it was time to bleed the engine and get ready for the moment of truth.
Do you believe in it?
And just like that, the engine rebuild was done and dusted. I hope it was useful to you, and thanks for watching.